watercolors, acrylics, printmaking, etching, oils. I do lots of things. Off on another tangent, so that's the way artists do. We don't tend to stick with anything too long. I was raised on a farm in central Indiana, and there wasn't a whole lot to do there. And I remember mixing up paints and painting fence posts and my mother's furniture and things like that. So I've always loved the smell of paint and chemicals and things like that. So I guess that's where it got started. Got married, had children, moved to Pennsylvania, and worked and so forth, and didn't start college till I was 30, that is, undergraduate. So when I'd go into classes, the students always thought I was the teacher. My husband took the job here, and I moved down here. And went to an art event over at school, and that got me hooked back into it, and applied and was accepted to graduate school, and studied mainly printmaking processes, but there you do all of it. To be a master's and all that, you have to do all of it. I guess it's the difficulty of it. That sounds kind of strange, but the challenge of it, because it's one of the most difficult two-dimensional processes you can do, because you're working against chemicals, the printing press, papers, humidity outside, if it's not right, conditions have to be just right, and you can work for weeks on an etching plate or something, print it, and then have it not turn out. Whereas a painting, you can paint it, either like it or you don't, and do another one. And so all the printing processes have their difficulties, but it's still one of my favorite things to do. So I'm going to do what's called a monotype print. It's like a printed painting. Mm-hmm. So I was always close to nature, and that reflects itself in my work even today. So I use a lot of natural elements, leaves, feathers, you'll see birds, all kinds of nature-related items in my work. I've got something worth looking at. When you do 2D stuff all the time, you want to get off the wall, you want to do something, create something else. I was enthralled with quarter-inch plate glass, mm-hmm. and the way it looks when it's stacked. Of course, I stacked it up this way rather than an easy way. Mm-hmm. And then I would put etching paste on it, and you could see through it. I would put different images on maybe 10 or 20 pieces of glass, and it would build the image up into one piece. What I call my box pieces. I have been doing prints a really, really long time, and I have stacks of things, drawers of things. And I thought, what can I do with those besides matting a frame hang on a wall? So I got these canvas pieces, and I cut up old prints. It's really fun to find a big print and find a piece that would just work and put it on the piece of canvas. So those are quite satisfactory to do. So years ago, I collected this sheet music, not knowing why. And so a friend of mine said, well, you know, you do a lot of things with birds. Why don't you draw, maybe put some birds on there? So I, well, that's a good idea. So I started using watercolor pencils and colored pencils, not watercolor per se, but the watercolor pencil, because the pigment is really strong. And putting birds and other things, but mainly nature images on there, on the original music, and now I have stacks. Literally, I've got stacks of sheet music. I've been picking it up. But I use the original music, and they've been pretty well received. Mm-hmm. So it's just really something really different. Make some money on it. So we can't do this for just mm-hmm. fun, you know. It's gotta be, we have to support our habit by getting some money for it. I guess you could call it an obsession. My friends and I talk about this a lot. We just have to do it no matter if we're not feeling well or whatever, but it's just, you're just driven to do it, that's all. I think anyone with a passion for whatever it is they do, they're driven to do that. That's what they were meant to do, and that's what you do. And we like to share it as much as we can.